Hello, GGT sports fan. Welcome to Manchester United versus Newcastle Premier League game preview. And it's so funny. Did you know that Newcastle have actually lost only one game, as you can see from the table? And they're actually number six right now at the table. They've only lost one game. And if you look at the game, I think they lost one game against Liverpool, in which Liverpool won 2-1. Out of the nine games that they have played, they have won three, they have drawn five, and lost only one. They are a very hard team to beat. I think this is one of the most weird weeks for Man United. It's going to be a difficult week because they play today against, tomorrow against Newcastle. After that, they will be playing the teams in the top half. They will play Tottenham on Wednesday and then Chelsea. These are very tough games, and Newcastle right now are in one of their best forms. It's going to be difficult to break them down. I'm hoping Man United is going to be able to play a beautiful game, probably play better than they played against Everton. Of course, Everton completely dominated the game, and against Ammonia we also dominated the game, but some of the teams that we struggle against are the low blocks, like you saw in against Ammonia, and also against Everton. But I'm hoping this game being a total of course, I am very sure Newcastle are not going to come all attacking. We might go for the low block, and we'll have to find a solution. They are possibly have rated more than us at Old Trafford, because we played the midweek, and most of our senior team players played in that game. Possibly they would have played a few minutes, but given the game how the game was, and we had to wait until the next 3 minutes to win. They played more minutes than they should have played. So it's going to be interesting to see how this game will turn out. But I think it's going to be a very difficult game at Old Trafford. So technically looking at the game, this has been the head-to-head games that we played the last four games. We played against the last three games we played, or the last four games we played against Newcastle at their home. It was 1-1, and you remember we won 4-1 in a game where Ronaldo was making his debut and return and scored two fantastic goals. Before that, we comfortably beaten them, but of course this is a different season. Newcastle, the new owners are very strong. They have some of the best players to watch. The likes of Bruno, Guimaraes, Maxima is back. I am hoping that Man United will turn up for this game, and show some hunger and, we really need to continue the consistency and win this game. So, in terms of the current form, if you look at both teams, United have technically won four out of their last six games and lost two, and they're currently fifth in the table. As I said, Newcastle, in their last nine games, have only lost one game, and this one they lost to Liverpool. If you look at it, these are the games actually. If you look at United, they won 1-0 against Ammonia. This is the current form. 2-1 against Everton, 3-2, beaten 6-3 with Man City, Sheriff, Real Sociedad beat us. So some of the games here are games that we really expected United to win. But if you look at their counterpart Newcastle has won. They beat Brentford 5-1. They also beat Fulham 4-1. They drew against Bournemouth. They drew against Crystal Palace 0-0. Liverpool beat them 2-1. They drew against Wolves. And remember, they also drew 3-3 against Manchester City. So their form is really good. They are very hard to beat. And if you look at even their scoreline here, they concede very... Here they conceded only one goal. The same here. So technically, if you look at it, then it means United have to score more than one goal for them to win. And they will have to find ways to score that one more than one goal, because the team here are not so easy to beat. You can see because they are conceding a very, very few. But having said that, let's look at the players that are missing. United technically have so many players missing. Wan-Bissaka, Maguire, Greenwood is suspended. McTominay is suspended. Donny van de Beek is not able to play. But of course, you have Martial from the team news. If you look at the Ten Hag record, that you say Martial is likely to come back into the team to play on Sunday. But for me, I don't think he's fit enough. But of course, having him in the bench is better. If I was to choose which team to go to, I would still go with the gear on the goal, Varane for coming in for Lindelof, you know, Martinez, and I would probably play Luke Shaw over Malacia, because I think Luke Shaw is coming back good. And given that Malaysia played in the midweek, I would play Luke Shaw there. And then I also have Dalot on the right. In the midfield, given McTominay suspended, I would go with a midfield of Casemiro, Bruno, and Eriksen, which technically is our best midfield so far. I don't think we can argue on that. It's our best midfield. And then front, I would play Ronaldo, keep Rashford and Anthony. But of course, Sancho played well when he came in against the money. And it's good to have a good bench. It's good to have a good bench, like just the same way we had against the money when the game becomes very difficult and you need new legs, new ideas to break it. And then you make the substitution, you can bring Martial in, probably for Ronaldo, bring Sancho in for Rashford, for Anthony. Yeah, Langa is also an option. So, but we really need to get creative to be able to break down this Newcastle team. It's a tough one, but of course, this is Old Trafford, and we should comfortably be able to push them, you know, have more possessions, have more goal attempts, and beat the Newcastle team. Talking of that, what as per the manager, Eddie Howe has really built a very good team in Newcastle, and you could clearly see what they're trying to do, how they're playing, and the motivation is so good. And I believe from what he says, you know, it's a tough place to go at Old Trafford to expect to win. It has been very hard for them for a while now. But if you can see, as he says, if you can go into these games with confidence and a good feeling, it gives you the best chance of a positive result. The next group of games are tough, but we are going to try and attack them, rise to the occasion, and give our all to get a positive result. Of course, I think they are going to attack. But I think they might be reduced to counter-attacks, which we've also been vulnerable to. We've considered goals before on counter-attacks, especially because Ten Hag likes to play high block. You know, technically our players are in the middle. So with the likes of Bruno Guimaraes, I think it's going to be very hard. And we'll have to really, really be on the lookout for those counters, because we can really, really attack from those counters. But I believe Newcastle are a very confident team right now. They're highly motivated, and they are going to give Man United problems at Old Trafford. That I can tell you, they're going to give Man United problems at Old Trafford. So it all depends on how it will be set up against them. And I'm hoping for a good game, of course. I'm hoping for a good game. Don't get me wrong. I'm hoping Man United wins this game, and I'm going to give my prediction at the end of this, video. I'll give you my prediction for this game. So let's look at the trend. Currently, these are the trend. United have achieved 3 straight wins in all their competitions. They've also not been beaten in 14 of their 17 most recent home games. In their 8 most recent Premier League, they have scored 1 plus goals. If you can remember, we literally scored more than one goal in our Premier League game. The last 4 home games in Premier League have been high scoring with over 2.5 goals scored. So you can see we can score goals. We also had to concede at home, I think so. But also Newcastle are undefeated in 11 of their last 12 games in all competitions. And they have scored more than one goal in those games. So you remember against City, they had a scoreline of 3-3. You know, Brentford, they recently beat Brentford 5, but Fulham 4. So it's not going to be an easy game. If you would ask for my prediction, these are my prediction. I think United are beginning to peak, and I believe a game like this one is where United can really turn up and hurt Newcastle. So I'm going for United win. My prediction would be a 3-1. I think we will concede a goal. I think in the counter attack we may prevent them, but I think they will be able to, with the likes of Saint Maxima, Bruno, and Almiron, I think they will sneak one goal in, but it will be a tough one for them at United. And given the form and the competition we have in the team, I expect us to score 3 goals. So my prediction will be a 3-1 goal. Thank you guys. All the best to the team. Let's meet on Sunday as we watch the game. And please, if you don't subscribe to our channel, please subscribe. Help us grow the channel. Click the notification bell and you'll be able to get all future videos that we make, a lot to do with Man United also, as well as betting predictions and so on and so forth. Thank you and enjoy your day.